Hello everyone, I am Nikita Tiwari and today we are going to start a new subject, that is computer system architecture, which is also known as computer system organization. So this subject is very important if we talk about any competitive exam related to the computer science, that is GATE, NET, ISRO, BARC, or any PhD entrance exam or postgraduate entrance exam. This subject carries huge marks with itself. So if you are planning to skip this subject for your next competitive exam, no, don't do this. This subject is also important for university purpose also. So we have planned this series in such a way that it will be helping the university students and the competitive exam students also. Along with the concepts, we'll be solving many previous year questions of the GATE, NET and ISRO, so that we'll have a good practice on the concepts which we will learn. So talking about the syllabus of this computer system architecture, it is mainly divided into three parts, that is basic computer organization and design, digital logic, circuit and components, and microprocessors. These three parts contain some more subparts with them, like basic computer organization and design deals with the hardware portion of our computer system. Digital logic, circuit and components deals with the logic circuit, Boolean algebra, combinational circuit, sequential circuit and everything. Microprocessor, in this topic, we are going to learn two types of microprocessors which are being asked multiple times in the competitive exams, that is microprocessor 8085 and 8086. We will be covering both these microprocessors along with their characteristic properties. So talking about the first part, that is basic computer organization and design, this topic includes instruction cycle, instruction code, instruction format. Like when we give any command or any instruction to the computer system, after we give the command, what is the processing computer system does and how do we get output of that particular instruction, that we are going to learn in these three topics, that is instruction cycle, instruction code and instruction format. And then we have some addressing modes, like how are variables and the data on which we are performing some operations are being stored, and how are we giving their address to the computer system. Basically, how we are giving address of those data in our instruction. So that we are going to learn in this topic, that is addressing modes. And then we have further more topics, like register, control unit, pipeline, input-output organization, memory hierarchy, and multiprocessor. We are going to cover each and every topic in very detail. Right now, we are just having the overview of the syllabus, because it is very important to know that what we are going to learn in that particular subject, and especially why are we learning that subject. So we will be just talking about the syllabus, And why are we learning, and what will be the topics we will be learning in the subject in this particular video. So the next point is digital logic, circuit and components. It comprises of digital computers, logic gates, as I have said, Boolean algebra, map simplification, combinational circuit, flip-flop, sequential circuit, decoders and multiplexers. And the last thing, that before starting with the actual topics, there are some prerequisite which we are supposed to have before starting the subject, that is data representation and computer arithmetic, because these two topics are being used throughout the subject. These are the very fundamental of computer system architecture, and if we have good knowledge of these topics, then we will have good knowledge of the subject as well. So data representation deals with the number system and conversion, as we have different number system in the computer system, like binary, decimal, hexadecimal and octal. And we will be learning about the complements, like mainly which we use mostly are the 1's complement, 2's complement, 9's complement, and 10's complement. Then we are having different types in which we can represent our numbers, that is fixed point representation and floating point representation. So we will be covering these topics and the questions on them in the next videos. The next thing which we have here is computer arithmetic, like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Mainly, we'll be learning the binary addition, binary subtraction, binary multiplication, and binary division. So if you already know all these topics, then you don't need to go through them. But if you're learning the subject for the very first time, I would recommend you that don't skip this part. First, make your concept on these topics strong and then move to the actual topic of the subjects. Thank you.